Hi, in this video, I'll give you my best pro tip on how to paint better hair for your characters. Before we start, my goal with this video is to give you the 20% skills that will give you 80% results. I want to give you the shortcut, the tips that will help you to go faster with your haircut without losing yourself into all sorts of back and forth and details. I'm going to try to give you a clear step-by-step on how to maximize your effort, and after that, all you have to do is to spend a little bit more time to polish your haircut, but the big of the work will be done. Let's get started. Okay, the illustration that I have here is actually a sketch that I started. I recorded a video. If you want to see how I created the sketch, you can click. I'll put the link in the description below. What I did is I started to render the illustration and then I deleted the hair so I could actually show you how I construct it. All right, let's start with tip number one, which is to always start with the darkest color. Now, if you're about to do something from imagination, I try to start with an idea of the colors that I want. These are the colors that I want to do for this haircut. And I prepare myself a little sphere like that. I like to do this so we have like a little gradient of the colors. You can see what kind of mix they're going to do together. And so for this palette, my darkest color would be that brown. And so that's what I prepared here. I have my darkest color as a base. The reason why you want to start with your darkest color, it's just going to be much easier to add layer after layer, a little bit more light, and to create a volume this way on your haircut. If you were to start with the pale color, it would be much more difficult to actually add the shadows. So if you start with the darkest color and start to add the light, it's going to be much easier. So that's tip number one. Okay, tip number two is to take the time to design your shadow and light. And what do I mean by this is, as a haircut, you're gonna have like shadows and light depending on your light direction. And what you wanna do is establish the major shapes that the light and shadow will form. So it's about design here. It's about looking at your haircut and being like, all right, what's gonna cast shadows? Where's the light is going to bounce and all that. So for this, you want to take a little bit more of your time. And I'm gonna go over my hair right here. I created myself a little mask here so I can like paint within the boundaries of that mask. And then I'm going to take just a little bit more of a paler color here. You don't want to go too pale. You want to go just a little bit more, adding a little bit more light. And on a new layer, very important, I'm using a saffron brush here. And I'm going to start establishing just a little bit more light. And you'll see in a second what I mean by this. So I'm going to use a saffron brush here as an eraser a little bit. And I'm going to delete the parts that I don't need. Like this is going to be in the shadow. This is going to be in the shadow right here. It's going to be casted. And so I'm deciding where the light is going to be and where my shadow are going to be. And that's why I'm going to create a new layer to create some more shapes. I'm seeing like a shape here that I think could be in the light. And you don't want to be too zoomed in for this. So I'm kind of designing this. You don't want to be too zoomed in. Like you want to keep some distance because you want to see the arrangement. Like you're trying to design basically what's going to be the first read from the viewer when they're going to look at that haircut. It's a great trick to actually apply to basically all your illustrations. To always kind of stay away, not zoom too much in, so you can have like the bigger picture of it while you're designing. When you tend to be too close, you tend to get yourself lost in details. And so for me, this is pretty much the base of the light and shadow that I want to have. You can see already, I'm going to put all those layers together by selecting them all and doing Command E. Now they'll be on one layer. And you can already see that there's a lot of volume. I'll take that for a second out. And you see, it's already like giving myself a little bit more of the volume. Now I understand a little bit more where the light is. And so that's my tip number two, is always take the time to first design the big shapes, the big light and shadow. This way is going to give you a roadmap of where to start painting the different locks of hair, which is the next step. All right, tip number three will be to paint each individual locks of hair one at a time. And for this, you want to create a new layer each time. So I'm going to create a new layer here. I'm going to bring back my palette here so I can see it. And for that, I have a great set of brushes that I'm going to use that are free to download. I'll put a link where you can download them in the description below. And what I like to use is this one, which is it's called the Lock 7. It has a little bit of, maybe I can just show you here. There's a little bit of texture on it. And yeah, I think it's working great for this. And so now what I want to do is to design each lock of hair one at a time. So I'm creating a new layer. I'm going to go a little bit more pale this time. And you see I have my lines here that represent each lock of hair. And what I'll do is basically just kind of start designing each individual locks of hair. And what I like to do is paint on new layer each time and then use the saffron brush as an eraser, and I like to delete both hands. And by doing so, it's going to give you a lot of volume to this haircut. Then I'm going to create a new layer and create a new lock, painting like this, and then using the saffron brush to kind of doing the fade out. Doing the same thing again right here. Adding one more. And so the idea would be to do this each individual lock of hair one at a time. Very important, because what you want to have is a little bit of irregularity. I think I had the same lock of hair on both layers. I'll create a new one again. You want to have a little bit of irregularity. So doing like one lock at a time is going to give you like that irregularity of like, all right, this one finishes a little bit before, this one is a little bit longer, this one is a little bit like shorter again. They have different shape, and that's going to show like the diversity in your hair. So that's tip number three, design each individual locks of hair one at a time. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to just speed up this video and finish the rest real quick. Alright, and that brings us to tip number four, which is to add some hue shift, or basically have a little bit of a change of colors within your colors. Now, I already have a few different colors. I have some, you know, some yellow, some orange, some red. So I already have what we would call an analogous color scheme here on the hair. And so that's great. But I can also add even more effects. Things like subsurface scattering, where the light goes within the object you're painting and creates that glowing, a very saturated color, can be added really easily with color blending modes like color dodge. So I'm going to take a new layer here, put it to color dodge. I'm going to take a saffron brush here. And with color dodge, what's interesting is you can go ahead and just try a few different things. I'll take out my color palette for now. I don't need it. You can try a few different things. Like if I take like yellow and usually a darker color with color dodge would work better. Yellow is going to get like very orange like this, which is could be nice. If I go green, it's going to get a little bit more realistic here. If I go blue, it's going to get a little bit more pink and desaturated. So there's something to just try here with this technique. In this case, I think I want the green here. I want something that's a little bit more flashy, but not too irreal. Like I want it to be realistic. This is not realistic. This is a little bit more realistic. So what I want to do here is just, I want to add a little touch of like, all right, so the light goes here and it kind of saturated a little bit more. I don't want to put it everywhere because otherwise, what's the point? I want to put it where I think the light is going to bounce a lot more. So like here, for example, and here, and yeah, on top of the head. It's going to create a focal point a little bit more on that haircut, making sure that your eyes are moving all around. So right now here is going to be more attractive around the face, which is perfect. And here is going to be a little bit less attractive. So that's tip number four, adding some hue shift with a color blending mode. Color dodge is a great one. You can also sometimes try the overlay. That could be interesting. But really, if you want some flashy colors that bring some saturation and some cool effects, color dodge is always a great one. And so that's tip number four, adding some hue shift. All right, tip number five is to add details, but add details mostly in the highlights. When you add details or if you add details everywhere, basically, it's going to attract your eye everywhere. And usually when an object receives light, that's where the light is that you'll see the greater amounts of detail. So it's a great way to basically trick the eye of the viewer into making believe that you put details everywhere, even though you put them just at a few places and the highlights are the place to do. So I'm going to create a new layer here. And for this, I'm going to use a texture brush. Very important to have a texture brush here. You don't want to paint details by hand. You have great brushes in the sets that I'm giving you. This one is definitely one of my favorite. It has a lot of details and texture in it. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the highest color here and I'm going to change the hue towards something a little bit more yellow and go a little bit more saturated and high in terms of colors. And then I'm going to go over my highlights on a new layer, very important. And I'm going to take my time here. What I want to do is to create a little bit more of details where the highlights are, where the light is flashing. So here, I'm doing that V shape here because usually hair will have some overlapping into the shapes, like the locks will overlap. And so by doing a V here, it's going to give that illusion that it's doing an overlapping. And then I'm going to once again kind of delete the two extremities to make it like kind of fade out. And I'm going to create a new layer and I'm going to do the same thing here. I might just change the V. Do something like a little bit more different here, something like that. And then another one here. Something like that. Create a new layer. Make it maybe a little bit bigger this time right here. And really let the texture brush do a little bit more of the work here. Then you can zoom in, zoom out to see what kind of detail you're creating. If you want some more, you can create a new layer, maybe go even more pale and try to really just add the details where the highlight would be the highest, basically. So I'm going to add a few more details here, deleting the extremities. And right now I'm very zoomed in. It's going to be very important for me to just zoom out in a second and see what I'm creating, because when you're zoomed in too much, you kind of don't see what you're doing. So right now it looks okay. So I'm just going to continue add a little bit more right here, trying to design that highlights. And so now you can see that it feels like there could be like details everywhere, but your eyes are attracted to the highlights anyway. So you don't have to start adding details everywhere and it's like small hair everywhere. You can add only into the highlight and it's going to give you the illusion that you put details basically everywhere. So once again, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to just fast forward a little bit and finish the details everywhere. So that's it. As you can see now, I have the basic color, the basic forms and shapes, then the basic locks, changing a little bit the hue, and added a few details. And those are the 20% skills that will give you 80% results. As you can see, it's looking almost done. What I have to do now is just to put a little bit more time to polish and add some details, make disappear the lines, make the roots of the hair, those kind of things, make the floating points of the hair at the extremities and all that. This will take a little bit more time, but if you're following these 5 tips one by one, you'll have 80% of your haircut done within just a few minutes. So I hope you like this tutorials. If you like it, make sure to subscribe and to put a thumbs up. And for the rest, I'll see you into the next tutorial. And that's it for this video. I really hope you liked it. If you wish to learn more about hair, I actually spent a lot of time creating an awesome masterclass, and I put it inside the Digital Pin Academy. In this masterclass, the Advanced Hair Masterclass, I basically teach a lot of my tricks on how to do macro detail hair, how to do backlit hair. I go into really more details on how to do roots, for example, and how to attach the hair to your head, basically. And so if you're interested in all that, you simply have to visit the Academy. I'll put a link in the description of this video. And as usual, if you don't want to miss anything, make sure to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next tutorial. Happy painting!